You guys remember the time as a child? But just as a refresher, The Time as a Child was a storyline, God forbid, is a storyline, from the long-running sci-fi television series Doctor Who, in which the Doctor finds out that she had a secret past life where she was the fucking progenitor of her entire species. Now, you may be wondering, George, what is this? I come to this channel for that one time you did an ollie, and the BTS docos of the films you work on, and the one where the cat dies. There isn't really a running format for this channel, is there? This one's gonna be a Doctor Who video, so just let that be known. I would say I'm a pretty big Doctor Who fan. I mean, I'm not the type to shout it in the streets, but I also did win Best Dressed at my local cinema's screening of the 15th anniversary special for my papier-mâché silence costume, if that gives you any ideas. I've seen the new series many times over, and quite a bit of the classic series. Now, I can't say I've seen enough of the classic series to comment on that as a whole, so I'll say this. The Timeless Child is perhaps the worst thing to ever happen to New Who. I'm gonna try and fix it. But before we can establish how to fix it, we first need to establish what's wrong with it. I made a list. Now, if you're a big Doctor Who fan, you could probably skip this section. We get it. There's more than enough people online who have articulated the problems. This is just compiling. But if you watched this episode and thought, you know, there's something wrong about this, I can't pinpoint. Or if you watched the episode and thought, you know, I'm pretty indifferent about this whole thing. Or even if you watched the episode and thought, you know, I really like this reveal, you're wrong. And that's fine, that's okay, you can have your own opinion, but you're wrong about it. And here's why. If you've seen the 2018 animated movie Into the Spider-Verse, you would know that the moral of the film is that anyone can wear the mask. It's a really positive message that says that it doesn't matter who you are, where you're from, how you were raised, anyone has the capacity to be Spider-Man. Now, the character of the Doctor works in quite a similar way, in that the Doctor isn't inherently special, it's what they do that make them special. The Doctor doesn't fly around saving people because she's a legend amongst the cosmos. She's a legend amongst the cosmos because she flies around saving people. The Doctor's just some guy who decided to steal a TARDIS and explore the universe. Anyone can wear the mask, anyone can save the universe. So long as you have a, you know, time-traveling spaceship and a radioactive spider bite. The Timeless Child reveal, however, tells us that the Doctor was never just some guy. In fact, it was the exact opposite. She was the guy. According to Chris Chibnall, the Time Lords, before they were Time Lords, found the Doctor as a toddler and experimented on her until they could splice her powers of regeneration and replicate it in every other Time Lord. The Doctor is now quite literally the progenitor of all Time Lord society. Without the Doctor, there would be no Time Lords, no regenerations, no funny hats. This plot development strips back a major component that makes the Doctor the Doctor. The everyman of it all. Anyone can save the universe, but it really helps on your resume if you're actually the messiah of your entire planet. The Doctor no longer falls into the archetype of a Spider-Man. Now it's more of a Prince Charles type. She never achieved greatness. She was just born into it. The Doctor is now this godlike figure. And you know what that means? Fuck all. In order to write a canon-altering revelation into a story, one would hope that there would be an effect on the canon of the story going forward. Chris Chibnall has done this interesting thing where, and I would commend him for it if it wasn't the worst thing in the world, where The Timeless Child has completely changed how one can view the history of this show, whilst simultaneously having little to no ramifications into the future. To put into perspective, another big universe-changing event from Doctor Who was the Time War. Russell T Davies in 2005 wrote a storyline in which the Doctor became the last of his kind. That is a massive plot development, with so much that they can and did do. It has been 17 years, and there are still lasting ramifications of that story in-universe to this day. The Timeless Children, the episode in which the Timeless Child revelation was revealed, ends with the Doctor telling the Doctor that this whole thing, you know, doesn't really matter. And in the episode since, the Doctor is ummed and ahed about whether she wants to get her memories back at that time, but it seems like the moral is that she isn't going to let this define her moving forward. And that's a really good message, you know, the allegory that people shouldn't let their trauma define them. Really great message. just not for this. Because for a reveal that's supposed to shake up our worldview of who the Doctor is, having it all be inconsequential in the long run really begs the question, why, perchance, did you do it in the first place? Speaking of who the Doctor is, the title of this television series is Doctor Who, which is a little reference, little Easter egg, to the character of the Doctor and how they're quite mysterious, enigmatic, character of unknown origin. You can see where I'm going here. Before this point, unless you subscribe to the Cartmel Master Plan or Expanded Media, the only thing we knew about the Doctor pre-running away with Susan and the TARDIS was that he made friends with the Master and went to Time Lord Academy. That's mostly it. Why did he run away from Gallifrey? Is Susan actually his granddaughter? What's his name? That's the question, isn't it? Actually, it's the title of the show. We jest. It's the intrigue. Do we want to know the answers to these questions? Yes. Will we get any form of satisfaction knowing these answers? No. Because the joy comes from the mystery itself. And so doing a PowerPoint presentation on the origin of the Doctor, it's kind of cringe. This one's more of a nitpick, but it's kind of a slight on William Hartnell's first Doctor, don't you think? Like, if someone asked him now, are you the first Doctor? He'd have to say, well, I mean, I guess I'm the first person to play the Doctor, but in universe, there was actually quite a few people before me to play the character, so there's much less of a significance to my character now. Also, I'm dead, so is this conversation happening in the afterlife, or have you reanimated me to ask me this? And if so, what does that mean? How long will this last? Am I alive? What is life? What is death? What have I missed? Do people still remember that I fucked up a line, but they put it in the final clip of the episode? Have they made a biopic about me yet? Did they put in the scene where I fuck up a line, but they put it in the final clip of the episode? So they did, those bastards. And finally, it literally, narratively, doesn't make sense. For reasons I'll explain later. It's fussing over the plot lines of a TV show that's, in essence, made for kids. Healthy?
I wouldn't look into it.
This is risky, but I'm gonna try and fight fire with fire. Timeless Child is a retcon of pre-established lore. Let's just retcon it. Right? Now, changing a storyline after it's happened is a tricky task and quite easy to mess up. See citation here. But if you were to retcon something whilst also building or reaffirming other established things, it might make it a bit more planned. Looking. The hard part is though, Chris Chibnall has written this in such a way that if the events are true, then they're so foundational to everything that it'd be impossible to retcon. Unless it wasn't true. What if the Master was lying? What if the Master is the Timeless Child?
Should the Timeless Child have been the Master
instead? Was the
Master
lying?
In this video, I'm telling you how imagine for a second the story is
what
I'm
saying. Could the Master, what are the arguments for saying that the Master
had a little story of the Timeless Child?
Which would then be slightly unhinged
as he is now.
The Master.
No. No, he wasn't.
Oh, you guys already discussed that? 2 years ago? Right. Fuck, I'm already 9 minutes in. This is the Master Plan, right? This is how we fix things. Now, I'll admit, it's not perfect, but it's better than what we have now. The Master is the Timeless Child, and I'll explain my reasoning using the same reasoning for why the Doctor shouldn't be. Starting with one. Now, this theory, while it does carry over some plot holes, such as, you know, if the power of regeneration comes from the Timeless Child and not exposure to the Time Vortex, then that would mean, for a hypothetical example, that a Time Lord couldn't be born just from two humans having sex in a TARDIS.
But that means, I'm afraid it does.
The Master being the Timeless Child, though, would fit better into the ethos of his character. Think about it. The Doctor being Space Jesus doesn't fit into who the character of the Doctor is. But one thing about the Timeless Child storyline that did work is the actions of the Time Lords.
One of them finding a lost child and experimenting and basically torturing them until they can exploit the power of regeneration for their own gain?
That's so them. That's so them. Of course they do some shit like that. That's the thing about the Timeless Child storyline. It could have been a good reveal. It could have worked It just didn't work. But with a master, it would make sense. Being abused by your own adoptive parent, dying over and over again just so they can steal something from you, it would send you mad. And the whole Messiah problem wouldn't exist. The Doctor, as the Timeless Child, tells us that the Doctor is special, destined from birth to be this hero. The Master, on the other hand, wouldn't be this biblical child born to save the universe, because he didn't. He's not a hero. Therefore, making him the cause, the creation of the Time Lords, is less a statement on him being special, and more on the Time Lords being corrupt and evil. This one may just be a subjective thing, but having the Master as the Timeless Child adds more depth for me to his character than it would with the Doctor. A common critique for this reveal is that it doesn't make the Doctor and the Master equal anymore, which is a big thing with their dynamic. Switching the Timeless Child to the Master would have the same effect, really. It would just change the Master to the special one. But I think it has more story potential than the alternative. The Doctor and the Master, having used to be best friends, perhaps still, is what's intriguing about their relationship. The Doctor has to fight this person that she loves, and now she has a constant reminder in her own body of the trauma that had been inflicted on the Master. We sometimes forget that the Master isn't just a crazy guy doing crazy shit. He's a crazy guy who's been through some crazy shit. The Doctor now knows that the reason she is alive and able to do good in the universe is solely because of the bad shit that had been done to the Master. But she still has to go up against him. This reason's pretty basic. The show's called Doctor Who, not Master Who, and so finding out about his backstory isn't as sacrilegious as finding out about the Doctor's. Reason number four, it fucks off Bill. In this case, we'd switch that to Roger Delgado, the first person to play the Master. The difference here, though, is that while Delgado is the first person to play the Master, he's not the first Master. When we first meet him in Terror of the Autons, he's already in his final incarnation, which gives us some canonical leeway to add some backstory for before he became Delgado. And because he's not technically the first Master, it doesn't come off as insulting to suggest that there were incarnations before him. And finally,
it literally, narratively, doesn't make sense.
For this one, there's only really one way I can decide whether the Master being a Timeless Child would fit into the universe of Doctor Who. And that is if I watch and analyze every single Chris Chibnall episode that references or alludes to the Timeless Child storyline.
Doctor Who, the complete Series 11 DVD box set.
I started this journey with Jodie Whittaker's... That's how you spell Whittaker? I'm having a flippin' aneurysm right now. Jodie Whittaker's second episode, The Ghost Monument. Thankfully, the only episode in Series 11 that references the storyline, and a reference so vague that it could literally, at this point, mean anything. They could well have just said,
"We see deeper though, further back. The storyline for Series 12 onwards that Chris Chibnall hasn't fleshed out yet because he's too focused on Graham's dead wife and the tooth guy. The guy with the tooth, the teeth on his face. From the last episode, he thinks that can carry the season as a major antagonist."
What did you just say?
I know, honestly, don't ask me. I have no idea what's going on in his head right now. If you want my advice, just appreciate the mundanity of all this shit here while you can, before it all goes off the rails, and not in a good way.
What are you talking about?
Nothing. Something vague allusions to your past.
Get out of my head.
Next up is the opener for Series 12, which...
Oh shit, I don't have Series 12 on DVD. I'm a Doctor Who completionist, and The Timeless Child was so bad that I didn't even get it on DVD. DVD!
The Spyfall two-parter is quite slim on Timeless Child references. However, since it's our introduction to this Master, there's a few things to unpack.
Can I just say, this has nothing to do with the Master plan. Spyfall, as a title? Absolute garbage. Absolute garbage. It's like you're putting a hat on a hat. It's like if I were to make a sci-fi homage, satire, parody, whatever, and I called it Sci-Fi Trek. It's like, yeah, I get it, you're doing a Star Trek thing, but did you have to put sci-fi there? Because it was kind of made clear already that it was a sci-fi thing. When you did a play on the the Star Trek part. So...
two things.
Okay, so the Master supposedly destroyed Gallifrey, killed everyone on it, all life on Gallifrey, just killed them all, or at least by the looks of it, destroyed one of the Citadels. Here are the two options. One, he found out that his ex-best friend and archenemy, the Doctor, was the Timeless Child and got a bit angry. The second option is that he found out that he himself was the Timeless Child, and he's had this memory revoked from him. Which one of those revelations would make you angrier? That someone that you hate has their DNA coursing through you, or that you were tortured as a child and had your memory wiped? Both of them are pretty bad things, I'll admit, sure. But one of them I feel I'd have a much more visceral reaction to, personally. The second thing is a line I literally just noticed. Let me get to it.
It's buried deep in all our memories.
It's buried deep in all our memories. How? I mean, if we're going with the fact that the Doctor is the Timeless Child, sure, it's buried in her memories. But why did he say it's buried in all our memories, if he didn't also remember it? That being said, though, if he's the Timeless Child, how does the Doctor remember it, and so forth, and etc. But it's something to note. So I've just finished Skyfall Part 2, shit title, but things are flowing pretty nicely. It seems that all the references to the Timeless Child are either super vague and don't really, like, matter as to what the details are, or they surprisingly fit. You know, I was a bit worried when I started on this little journey, because I thought maybe there's going to be a lot of things that are just going to refute this plan. But it seems pretty good so far. It seems like everything's just, maybe not perfectly, but everything's really just slotting right into
play. Hello, I'm the Doctor.
That doesn't make sense!
Doesn't make sense.
It's fine. It's fine. If we're going with the whole Master is telling a lie about the Timeless Child thing, then for all we know, this Ruth character could be an actor. You know? There's no solid, you know, concrete evidence that she is the Doctor.
Same person.
They just had to put that in, didn't they? They just had to put in a line where the sonic screwdriver scans her and it confirms that it's exactly the Doctor, doesn't it? No leeway at all. Okay, what about this? If the Chameleon Arch can turn a Time Lord into a human, then surely it could work the other way around. What if somehow... Roll with me on this one. Roll with me on it. What if somehow the Doctor took a fucking Chameleon Arch, turned herself into a human, and then this Ruth character got that Chameleon Arch, opened it, and took in the Doctor's consciousness? Now, I'm not sure how fully that lines up with the canon of Chameleon Arch, because I'm pretty sure... Editor George, can you just check that and make sure that... Does that check out? After Fugitive, there are a few references here and there during the rest of the season, but mostly just to remind us that this is a continuing storyline. The next time the storyline actually comes up, though, is... Oh, God.
Just down there.
I just think it's interesting that it's the Master telling you this story. Sure, it's a framing device, you know, there needs to be some sort of narrative reason to dump all this exposition, but I don't know.
It just fits.
After making this statement, I then proceeded to basically immediately fall asleep and fade in and out of consciousness for the rest of the episode, but I think Sleepy George had a point there. For the episode that reveals the Doctor as the Timeless Child, it probably has around the least amount of concrete evidence to actually back that up, other than the word of the Master, which is looking to probably be our smoking gun here. All we'd have to worry about now is, well, Swarm and Azure corroborating the fact that the Doctor has a history she can't remember, the Extraction Squad of Angels corroborating that the Doctor did in fact work for the Division, the Doctor being thrown back into her own time stream where she was in fact the Fugitive Doctor, Tek-Teyun existing.
Is what the Master told me true?
Yes.
It's fine. It's all explainable. It's all explainable. And I'll explain it. Swarm and Azure. Actors, working for the Master. Extraction Squad of Angels. Sure, actors, also working for the Master. He's worked with a bunch of villains before, it's fine. Doctor and the Fugitive Doctor being the same person. That scene had Dan playing Carbonista, Yaz and Binder being who knows what. There was body swaps going left, right, and center. That proves nothing. Tek-Teyun.
That one question. That's the nagging at you.
Tek-Teyun.
The one thing he said that you didn't understand.
The Master.
No.
Is what the Master told me true.
Yes.
That's it. Actor. She's a fucking actor working for the Master. Why else would she know what the Master said? The Doctor never said in that scene anything that the Master said, and yet she still responded.
Yes.
Sure, the Division's this all-seeing, omnipotent organization, but I don't think they can keep that closer tabs on the actual conversations the Doctor has. Otherwise, they would have found her earlier rather than getting a flipping Extraction Squad of Angels together. And the Fob Watch, the flipping Fob Watch, it's the Master's Fob Watch, alright? He's taken all his memories of the Timeless Child and put it into this Fob Watch. It's all this intricate conspiracy planned by the Master, getting this actor to play Tek-Teyun, to basically gaslight the Doctor into opening this Fob Watch of memories that aren't hers, so she'll become the Timeless Child rather than the Master, so she can feel what he felt. That's it. It must be. I figured it out. Master isn't the Timeless Child. This isn't going to be fixed. Chris Chibnall has one episode left as of recording this. Do you really think he has the capacity to pull a solution for any of this out of his hat? Or if he even wants to? I doubt RTD is going to bother dredging this train wreck up. Maybe that's how it should be. Let this thing be lost to the sands of time. Forget about it. That's looking to be the best, well, most realistic solution here. Ignore it. Move on. Done it before. Who's to say we can't do it again? That's the beauty of this show. The reason why it's lasted so long. You forget about all those shitty stories. And you remember the great ones. And as for the Timeless Child, maybe that's already begun. You know, I went to a quiz night with my girlfriend a couple weeks back. And one of the questions they asked was, what's the name the actor who played the first incarnation of the Doctor in Doctor Who? I answered William Hartnell. They marked me correct.
How will they explain this tomorrow?
You'll all forget it ever happened. I forgot the last time. You remember the fear, and you put it into fairy stories. The human superpower, forgetting. Remember how things felt. You've stopped having wars. And stopped having babies.